Welcome to our series of PowerCore training videos. Today's video is called the Application Configuration Menu. Well, let's get into the menu. And go down and highlight with the down arrow. We'll highlight Application Configuration. Hit enter. The first item is the actual application that you have. Pump All Purpose is the default. This gives you all the options in the auto start and throttle methods. If you choose a specific application, such as center pivot, air compressor, hose reel, frost protection, any of these, you're limited on your choices. Let me do that. For instance, in frost protection, you can't select floats for start-stop because we just don't use floats in frost protection. So that's the idea behind this menu. So if you leave it at all, pump all purpose, you get every option you have. So that's fine, and that's the default. Auto start function. It defaults to two contact maintain, which basically is floats. You can have a single contact. Local key start, which are these buttons right here, same as the buttons that you'd use for manual start. Two contact maintain floats, two contact momentary is where the contacts don't have to be present, just has to be there for a brief amount of time. Pressure transducer, level transducer, and flow transducer. Modbus auto start stop override. It defaults to disabled. If you say enabled to that, that allows a Modbus start independent of the start-stop types you have. It's kind of a handy feature. So if you had floats selected, but you wanted to do a Modbus start independent of that, you could do that if you enabled that feature. Auto throttle method. Running loaded RPM is the default. Hit enter. You have pressure transducer, level transducer, flow, and local throttle input, which is the pressure level and flow is where we would maintain a value for throttling between the minimum and maximum RPM set points. And the local throttle input is where we get an analog in that we don't know what it represents, but we throttle between minimum and maximum RPM set points proportional to that analog. But we don't know what it represents. We don't care. It's just a percentage to us. Auto throttle type. There's non-PID, which is the default, PID, and then linear throttling. Linear throttling gets you where there's no set point to maintain, such as level. You can throttle between the min and max pressure or level proportionally between the two set points with no level maintained set point. That's used for perhaps smaller sumps that you don't want to chase the level. You want to have the RPM and the level track together. Auto running loaded speed, it defaults to 2000, but again, you can change that. Keep in mind that the maximum RPM set point that we covered in the previous video overrides the auto running loaded speed. So for instance, if you had a lower maximum RPM than the running loaded RPM, it's only going to go to the maximum. The maximum overrides this. So if we go back, I want to cover one thing in this. If you make selections, just like in other menus, when you make a selection for a feature, you may lose or gain more items in the menu. For instance, if we go to auto throttle type and select pressure transducer, hit enter, then we have more set points. We have the pressure transducer set point, which just appeared because I chose pressure transducer for a throttle. If you hit enter, now you have a maintained pressure set point, a dead band, pressure type, whether it's discharge or suction, line fill, which is a feature we put in there when we're filling a line, maybe 1 or 2 miles long, that's got air in it, and we want to hold the RPM down low to allow the water to fill the line up before we actually go up and throttle the pressure. So you've got a line fill speed, a line fill delay, and a line fill pressure. So that's one of the states it will go through if you select values in there. All right, I think this concludes the application configuration menu. Thank you.